Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Friends, welcome back to my channel. I received this comment from my viewer and my valuable friend, Mr. Shabir from Pakistan. He sent me the picture of this module. It is a power Darlington transistor for old-fashioned UPSs. It is 200 ampere, 300 ampere switches. It is AEG. And it have also from the Sanyo and different other brands. Its part number C300R600K. So it is 300 ampere, 600 volt. I printed out its picture and he sent me this audio note.
Assalamu alaikum. Mr. Saab Shabir, Darbella to okay, I'll let you say it. ਛੋਟੇ ਜਿਹੇ ਮਸਲੇ ਮੈਂ ਫਸ ਗਿਆ ਸਾਡੇ ਕੋਲ ਇੱਕ ਇਨਵਰਟਰ ਹੈ ਅਤੇ ਉਸਦਾ ਇਹ ਪਾਵਰ ਬਲਾਕ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਇਸਦੀ ਪਿਕਚਰ ਮੈਂ ਭੇਜ ਰਿਹਾ ਅਸੀਂ ਨੈਟ 'ਤੇ ਸਰਚ ਕਰ ਰਹੇ ਹਾਂ ਇਸ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਡੇਟਾ ਵੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਮਿਲ ਰਿਹਾ ਦੂਸਰੀ ਗੱਲ ਇਹ ਵੀ ਕਿ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਟੈਸਟ ਕਰਨੇ ਦਾ ਅਗਰ ਕੋਈ ਤਰੀਕਾ ਪ੍ਰੋਸੀਜਰ ਕੋਈ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਜ਼ਹਿਨ ਵਿੱਚ ਹੋਵੇ ਤਾਂ ਪਲੀਜ਼ ਸਾਡੀ ਹੈਲਪ ਕਰੋ
ਹੀ ਟੋਲਡ ਮੀ ਦੈਟ ਹੀ ਇਜ਼ ਵਰਕਿੰਗ ਔਨ ਸਮ ਪਾਵਰ ਇਨਵਰਟਰ ਪਾਵਰ ਯੂ ਪੀ ਐਸ ਐਂਡ ਦਿਸ ਮੋਡਿਊਲ ਡੋਂਟ ਹੈਵ ਐਨੀ ਡਾਟਾ ਔਨ ਦਾ ਇੰਟਰਨੈਟ ਇਫ ਦੇਰ ਇਜ਼ ਐਨੀ ਟੈਸਟ ਪ੍ਰੋਸੀਜਰ ਸੋ ਲੈਟਸ ਸਟਾਰਟ First of all, we will see its internal structure. These power modules, power blocks, these are used in 30 kVA to 100 kVA UPSs, old fashioned in the early 90s. Approximately 25 years ago, I worked on these type of inverters, these type of machines. It is complete Darlington pair. It have two transistors inside. The one that is power transistor, it is 200 ampere, 300 ampere switch. Most of the time it is NPN. Then the second transistor here, it is used to switch this transistor. A low value signal is here, we can say it is a signal transistor, and this is power transistor. It have one terminal here, second terminal here, and it have three terminals here. This is collector, emitter, base, and here is BX terminal, and here is E terminal, emitter. So two emitter terminals are here. If we see this collector, it is connected to recovery diode. There is a recovery diode between collector to emitter. And from this collector, the second collector is connected together. So this one is collector, emitter, and emitter have two connections. One connection here, the second connection is two connections here, emitter, emitter. One is for signal return and this one is power. And here is B, base, and then there is BX. Here we have BX terminal. So these terminals are extra terminals. This is for test purpose. Normally in 150 ampere, 200 ampere Darlington modules, these terminals are not available. There is base, emitter, collector. How we can test it? If you see here, this one is collector. This pin is emitter. This one is BX. And this one is emitter, E. And here is B. Base. I don't have the original module here, but I made a simplified circuit, equivalent circuit to this module. Now we will see how we can test it. I will connect to collector, emitter. I connected two transistors in the same configuration here. This is the second emitter. Its internal connections are exactly the same as I am making here. This is emitter. This one is base. And this will go to this terminal. BX emitter, emitter and this emitter are connected internally. Both collectors, this collector and this collector are connected here. Here I am connecting the 2012 transistor. Let's test it. I will make the same connections here, so we will understand how we can test it. In the first step, we will test this base to BX. Base, BX, and then we will test base to collector, and then we will test from collector to emitter, and then BX to emitter and BX to collector. So here we have two emitters and we will see the reading. Set multimeter to diode mode and now connect red lead to the base and this one to the BX. Here is base and here is BX. Base to BX, one diode forward bias. We connected red lead at base and black lead at BX. Other pins not connected, so it will give one diode forward voltage, 0.6 volt. Check again, base, this is base terminal and this one is BX terminal. So it is good. We tested this junction. Now base to collector. When we test this one, so it will test red lead at base and black lead at collector, 0.6 volt. And if I will reverse the leads, black lead at base, red lead at BX, red lead at collector, it will open. Red lead, base, black lead, here red lead, open. Black at collector, red, open. These not connected. Okay. We tested this transistor. Now connect one lead at BX and check between emitter. So here is BX. We will connect a red lead at BX and we will test this emitter. BX to emitter, one diode. BX to collector. Now we are testing this junction. Collector, emitter. BX red lead, collector, black, 0.6 volt, red, emitter. In the first emitter, black, 0.6 volt, BX red. Second emitter, this one BX and this one, it must be the same reading. So both emitters, this emitter and this emitter must be connected together. Red, black, continuity. Now check between emitter to collector. Red lead at emitter, black lead at collector, red lead at emitter, black lead at collector, 0.6 volt. In this way. When we test in this way, we are testing this diode. And now reverse the leads. At collector, red lead, emitter, black lead, open. If we find continuity in this area, in this set, at that time the power diode and power transistor are short circuit. This is the most important testing. If we find any reading other than these parameters, that module is bad, we need to replace it. When we checked base to BX, we tested this base to BX, this junction, and then base to collector. So base to collector, we tested this junction. We tested both junctions of this transistor. So it is now clear. Then BX to emitter. Here is BX to emitter. We tested this junction. Then BX to emitter second. So we tested this connection. That's okay. Then BX to collector. This BX to collector, we tested this junction. Then we checked this diode between collector to emitter. I hope you enjoyed this video. If it is good, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.